Welcome to TECHNOSLAV. Watch this video in 1440p if you can. It's the Slav resolution times 10. Everyone agrees that video games and computers are as good together as vodka and pickles. But you know, computer is not just a magical black box that just works. It has distinctive parts, each with their role and task. For video games, two components are most interesting to discuss. The CPU, central processor, and GPU, the graphics processing unit. Let me tell you and show you what CPU and GPU have to do in games. And after that, I will explain why it's not always true that you need fast processor for fast graphics card. Prepare for this ride on technology. Maybe you'll have to take it twice. Поехали! The heart of every computer. The central processor, CPU, central processor, is a strong dictator that runs everything across your motherboard. It can run long, complicated programs of any kind. In video games, your processor manages system memory, game resources, artificial edits, collisions, physics, animations, and so on. Modern processors have multiple computing cores and threads, meaning that they can do several tasks simultaneously, and modern games are taking advantage of this. One CPU thread can work on collision, another on sound, third on AI, and so on. The result of these many calculations is a wireframe made of polygons. These will be filled with juicy graphics by your graphics card. GPU or graphics processing unit isn't as smart as a central processor, but it isn't any less interesting. So what does it do in games? In a nutshell, GPU receives wireframes from the CPU. Then, it fills those triangles with pixels and sends complete pictures, frames, to your screen. Modern GPUs are very fast thanks to thousands of shader cores. They all do simple tasks in parallel, which is perfect for image rendering. Graphics cards can render pictures in a wide range of resolutions and quality. Here are a few examples of how geometry and graphics have been evolving in video games in over a decade. Now let's talk about performance. Let's say you want 60 frames per second. This gives your computer 16.7 milliseconds per frame. To keep things simple, let's say it has to deal with AI collision and wireframe in this frame. So what happens if it takes longer time than 16.7 milliseconds per frame? Obviously you're not getting your 60 FPS. What can you do about this? Obviously you can reduce settings that affect wireframe. Geometry quality, view distance, sometimes also called mesh quality, and draw distance. So, in order to demonstrate this, I am going to slow down my computer, my processor, by around 3 times, so I am going to get massive bottlenecking on CPU in Stalker. I enable my power saving mode, go to Stalker, now I have around 35 FPS. Unacceptable shit. So I go to settings and reduce my geometry quality and draw distance settings. Now I'm having between 55 and 60 FPS in this spot depending on where I'm looking. Graphics didn't get that much worse, however over longer distances it is quite shitty. You can easily notice that the hill on the right looks much worse than before. Now this is getting quite interesting, because, you know, I reduced my graphics settings, but now I am getting higher GPU usage. However, it's not yet time to celebrate, because due to very short draw distance, stuff is popping out of nowhere. So let's increase settings a little bit. Yes, this looks much better, Now the hill doesn't look like a potato. Let's go outside. Well, this makes a world of difference. Yeah. Now I'm still having decent FPS boost and decent draw distance. It doesn't even look much worse than ultra quality, while I'm having up to 50% FPS boost. Now, let's check out Battlefield 3. Really, it's hard to get reliable performance metrics in multiplayer, but we can still see noticeable performance difference by changing mesh quality. We have between 40 and 50 FPS on ultra quality right now. Once we drop mesh quality to low, we get between 50 and 60 FPS, which gives us 22% performance increase in frame rate. If your processor is slow, first setting to decrease is mesh quality. In Battlefield 4 on empty server, ultra settings, besides rendering resolution, we have around 50 FPS. Once we decrease mesh quality, the FPS goes up to 60, which is 20% FPS boost for just one setting. Decreasing every other setting gives us another 10 FPS. As you can see, mesh quality in Battlefield is the one that affects central processor. All other settings are mostly GPU dependent, especially shadow and particle quality. Open world games mostly aren't so well optimized for processors, especially aging MMOs such as World of Warcraft and Elder Scrolls Online. Even if you have fast processor, decreasing view distance and other settings that decrease wireframe complexity is a must if you want to have 60 FPS in cities and other detailed locations. With decreased view distance, we get close to 60 FPS, but the GPU is still not loaded to 100%. We can increase GPU intensive settings, for example subsampling quality, and now GPU is close to 100% load at around 60 FPS. Now, when we leave the city, CPU usage decreases a lot and the GPU now is constantly at maximum load during the fight. This is not really good, because any extra effect will make the FPS dip below 60. These particle effects are very heavy on GPU. You should probably think about it before you crank up your settings in a city where you don't have as many particles as in a fight. From left to right, in one game, on one computer, we went from massive CPU bottleneck to balanced load at nearly 60 FPS, and then we went to complete GPU bottleneck by changing settings and going from one place to another. Now, just for a quick recap, we have processor that has to make frames. Complicated frames take longer time, so we simplify frames, so we get 30 frames per second. Then we send them to GPU. Well, GPU is not at 100% load. Increased graphic settings. GPU is at 100% load. Problem solved. Now go, use this knowledge to optimize your settings to get best out of your computer in games.
Ну, Cheeki, breeki, в дамке!
Братва, тут я один тупой, или все не поняли? Это типа про чё?